So let me set the scene for you. You're excited. You just got one of these Chinese 8 GPU mining cases. You got your cursory shipping damage. You've got this 2000 watt power supply. And you go for the first time to turn it on. And you hear that. Well, that's just super annoying. It blows a whole lot of air. But at least this one's facing the right way around, blowing out. The first case I got, this was blowing in. But you want to keep this in your residential location, and that is just too loud. What do you do? Well, on my last one of these, I put a 5-watt resistor on the negative leg of the fan, and everything ended up working okay. So that's what I'm gonna do to this case as well, and I'll show you basically what I'm doing. I don't recommend you do this because you are cutting some airflow that technically this is supposed to have, and especially if you're running more than like 1100 watts through this, or it's a really hot environment, you might actually burn it up. These supposedly do have over temperature protection. However, I'm not sure if I would trust it. So anyway, proceed at your own risk, but I've been using one of these in a reasonable ambient environment with 1200 watts on it with no issues with the resistor mod. So again, without further ado, I'm gonna shut this back down in the software, and then I will show you exactly what I'm gonna do once I remove the power supply from the case. So here's the power supply bracket I took out, and then there's also 5 screws that fasten it at the back. I would highly recommend that you have this off for a long period of time disconnected from the wall before you open it. If you do, actually, I don't even recommend you open this because there are some big capacitors in this and there is serious risk of injury or death if you don't know what the hell you're doing. But I'm gonna go ahead and open mine up and I'll take a look at the actual fan connector. Okay, so here we see what we have going on. See this connector, which is for your switch down here. A little bit odd that it doesn't actually interrupt the current flow, but you can see your fan right here. And there's our connector, which terminates all the way back on the board right there. So what I'm going to do is disconnect that from the board. And I'm going to cut back some of this jacketing to get access to the black wire inside. So there you can see what I've stripped back. Now I'm actually going to cut a little section of the black wire out. And the reason why I go with the black one and not the red one is this is, in theory, 12 volt DC ground. So if this touches anything else in the power supply, the worst it can do is destroy the fan or run it at full speed. If you were to cut into the 12 volt and that touched the ground, you would end up with a big old pop and you'll definitely blow up the power supply. So I'm going to cut out at least an inch of this, and then I'll show you the resistor that I'm planning to solder in. And yes, there's cat noises. So you can see, I mean, it's a big resistor, so you got to cut a chunk of that out, but I'm going to cut some out, strip back the jacketing, and then wrap them, preparation to tin and solder them. All right, that's about the right length. So now I'm going to tin all 4 ends before I try to solder them together. There we go. Sorry, I cannot solder and hold the camera at the same time with such tiny wires. And I'm gonna wrap it all up in Captain tape and shove it back where it belongs. And there you can see it. So time to seal her back up. Okay, now. And yep, that's still pushing a good amount of air. But now it's nice and quiet. Now you can hear the big fans. And luckily it looks like all these even work. My first one, which was really shipping damaged, had 2 dead fans. You can see we're booting into Hive up there, so. Again, I don't necessarily recommend. In fact, I recommend that you do not do this, just because there is some extreme potential hazard inside of this box, and you might overheat it and kill it, but I have personally been using one of these with this mod in a hotter environment with 8 3060 Ti's running on flux at 1050 watts for at least 2 weeks, and so far everything's still working. So anyway, that is how I modified my cheapo 8 GPU mining rig to be usable in a quieter environment.